Hi, and welcome to StampingSmiles.com. I'm Shelley Godby, the owner and CEO of Stamping Smiles, and today I want to share with you my two-second tag tip. I was making a card for my 25 days of retiring Stampin' Up! Stamp sets. I'm doing a series on my blog, so you'll need to go check that out now, and I wanted to use the Easy Event stamp set, because it will be retiring too, and available to purchase through June 3rd, 2013 only, in my online store. And I needed to make a tag, and I thought, oh, I think they would like to know how I did this. So that's what I want to show you. Let's get busy. Before Stampin' Up! Had the Tag Corner Punch, what I'm about to show you is what I always did. And then since they've retired, I continue to do this. So this is the piece of cardstock I want to make my tag out of. It's 2 by 3 1/4 Whisper White cardstock. And so I like to take a piece of scrap cardstock of the same size. The width is what's really important, but for me it's easier if the length is 2. And so then I take my paper snips and I trim off 1 corner. And now I have created my template. And so I set this over there. See why it's easier if the length is the same? And I cut right along here. Because to cut 2 of these the same way on both sides to turn it over and get it would almost be impossible. So what I do is turn this over. Look at that. And you can't help but get 2 angles that are the same. Now how is that for a 2-second tip? For my Easy Events card, I chose this pattern from the International Bazaar Designer Series paper, and I chose it because of the design and the colors, and I just really liked how these colors were going to work for my cuckoo clock. And the green for the leaves would be great, and the brown for the cuckoo clock, and so then I wanted a watercolor. And the green in here is Lucky Lime, so you push down with your thumbs and get some color in that lid. Take your aqua painter, and then you just start coloring in. And with this, I love it because I like to also squeeze in a little ink refill so I can get some depth of color. So I can get different shades. So I can come over here and pick up a little bit and go along that stem and just have a ball coloring in. Don't try to get perfect. And just use the rest of the colors to color all of this in. And then I want to show you what else I do with my designer paper. So here we are with it all colored in. We have from that paper the Pacific Point on my bird and the Tangerine Tango and the Chocolate Chip and the Daffodil Delight. And so I'm using the colors from there. Isn't that attractive how it coordinates? Okay, so then when I went to adhere this, I turned it over to put my adhesive on there, put my stale adhesive on there. I thought, oh, I like that pattern too. Especially, isn't that pretty against the chocolate chip? Like, now what do I do? I like both of them. Well, this is what I did. I really did want to stick with this because I like the leaves and the brightness of it. So I have a little piece left, and so this is 2 inches across. And so we're going to put some snail on here. And I thought, won't that be pretty? Because the papers are designed to coordinate not just in color, but complementary patterns. So I don't have that on there straight. Let me get that on there straight. It needs to be straight. Okay. And so I thought, isn't that pretty? And that contrast and coordination. But then I want to be a little bit even more pretty. So I have my scallop edge punch. And I'm just going to fit this right down in here. And let's punch off a coordinating bottom. Oh, just a little bit more. Okay, it was just a little bit too wide to get the whole thing. Thought I might get away with it. But that's what the guides are great for. I'm using the guides. See right here, these scallops. Put this in. And I'm following that guide, so then I can just clean that off. Isn't that sweet? So now I got to use both sides of my paper. So here we have my finished Easy Events card. And behind here, I've die cut with the Delicate Doilies. Sizzlet's die. Isn't that fantastic? And so it's chocolate chip on chocolate chip. And I have a button from, a Daffodil Delight button from the Brights buttons. These are retiring as well. And I put in here some early espresso baker's twine. Now I know it isn't chocolate chip, but it is so tiny, I thought it'll be just fine, and I really think that is. And so there we have a card. And so this is one of my 25 days of retiring Stampin' Up! Stamp Set series that I'm doing. This will be on my blog, so you want to go check that out because I am doing counting down the days that we can still order retiring Stampin' Up! Stamp sets. We have through June 3rd, and so I'm counting down right now with the 25 days. And you know what? Exclusive for my mailing list subscribers, I am doing a five-week series of exclusive projects, and they're from God Be With Us Stampers. And they have graciously provided samples to share with you their talents and all the stamp sets are retiring. But in order to get those, you have to be on my mailing list. So under the screen, I'll have a clickable link for you to join my mailing list so you can get the remaining 3 weeks. The first two have already gone out, but we got 3 weeks left of exclusive samples. And then, of course, go to my stamping blog and enjoy my 25 days of retiring Stampin' Up! Stamp sets. And of course, Easy Events is available in my online store, so you can go there right now and get this great set before it's gone. It has so many great occasions. It's just so sweet. So be sure to join my mailing list to get those remaining 3 weeks of the five God Be With Us retiring Stampin' Up! Stamps. I'm Shelley Godby, teaching you how to create hand stamp smiles. Thanks for watching.